Hey, so I will kickstart this. So, good evening, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us today for our first office hours for UCSF Digital Health Awards 2020. Thank you so much for taking out this time on a Friday evening. And I'm Moindrila. I am a part of UCSF Health Hub. I take care of marketing at UCSF Health Hub. And I'm joined today by my colleagues, Ruthvik and Aneri. Between the three of us, our objective today is to give you an overview of the awards process this year, the details on the categories, the judging criteria, the process, the stages, followed by a quick demo of our actual submission portal, of what it looks like, what are the questions there, how long does it take, and what might be the common queries that you might have. The last 10 minutes of today's call would be dedicated to answering any question that you have. And we're recording this call and we will be sharing the recording with you. But if you still have other questions, please feel free to join us for any of our other upcoming office hours. We plan to do this every 2 weeks, right from now up to the end of the submission process. So, you all know, like, the application process has started. We started this June 3rd, and this would go on till August 3rd. So till such time, every 2 weeks, we will be coming together and solving any question that you have on the process. Okay, so a lot of you have been a part of our journey last year for our inaugural Digital Health Awards in 2019. And I see a lot of you who are new. So I wanted to quickly start by giving an introduction about ourselves, UCSF Health Hub. So we are a growth studio based out of San Francisco and deeply connected with the UCSF ecosystem. Our work primarily is to help early stage digital health or health tech companies get connected to the help they need in form of advisors, mentors, or investors, so that we can help them accelerate breakthrough digital solutions faster. Our flagship event is the UCSF Digital Health Awards. This is, since its inception last year, it is now considered as the Academy Awards of Digital Health. It is the biggest industry awards event in healthcare, and it is the kind of the gold standard in digital health solutions. Why we are doing this is very simple, actually. There are so many solutions available in the market today. And our objective with this is really to show the spotlight on those technologies that truly represent a breakthrough. By doing this, we want to make it easier for patients, providers, payers, customers, VCs, and any other healthcare system really to find out which are the solutions which are the best available in the market. And to throw a spotlight on them so that people can know more about them, they can be recognized, and people can find them more easily. This is our second edition this year. And we are not in this alone. This year, we are seeking applications from mature US-based companies who have a validated in-market solution, which is purchasable in the US. We are doing this awards in collaboration with 30 of the biggest healthcare VCs, incubators, innovation studios, and growth studios in the US. We are all coming together to make this happen. Our 2019 winners are available on our website. They represented some of the best solutions that were available last year, and they are joining us this year as well. This last year, these winners came for our live event in San Francisco in the UCSF campus, and were presented the awards live. This year, we are all virtual, and our format is going to be very different, but it's going to be awesome. So starting this July all the way till September 23rd, we're going to have a series of virtual events where we will be announcing winners. We'll have keynote presentations from some of the biggest thought leaders and luminaries in digital health. We will have breakout sessions. We'll have spotlights on all these companies who progress through these different stages in our competition. We are going to have mentor workshops. We're going to have a bunch of other interactive, cool, innovative formats, and we'll be sharing more details on that very, very shortly. This year, the awards will be judged by 250 of the most eminent and distinguished healthcare leaders in the US. They consist of VCs, representatives from UCSF, physicians, patient body representatives, healthcare system representatives, the biggest digital health luminaries in the country, honestly. And we will also be joined by our last year's winning CEOs as judges for some of our categories. A lot of this information is available already on our website, so please feel free to go and visit our website and check out the details. This year, the competition is divided in 4 stages. Right now, you all are submitted entries to the preliminary stage. After this, all qualified entries, which meet the basic minimum criteria, will be judged by our panel of judges to identify our quarterfinalists, which are the top 14 companies in each category. After which, sometime in September, actually, our semifinalists would be announced, and they are the top 4 companies in each category. And finally, we'll be announcing the winners during our grand finale on September 23rd. I will now be handing it over to Aneri, who's going to talk to you more about our categories and our judging criteria. And like we said, towards the end, we'll take all the questions, and feel free to write. You can type the questions in the chat box right now or later on, and we'll answer all of them. So over to you, Aneri.
Thank you, Anjula. I'm just going to share my screen. So here on the About page, we see this dropdown where it has the categories. So I just wanted to quickly take you guys through the categories that we have this year. The first one is behavioral health. The second one is best COVID solutions. So anything that's a digital health solution that is for the COVID response or COVID mitigating, we wanted to include that. And this would be 3 awards. We haven't figured out how we're going to divide these top 3 into subcategories yet, but that will be done once we actually get applications. Then we have Best of UCSF, which is the best new digital health solutions coming out of UCSF. This also has 2 subcategories, Best Newcomer, which is if you were founded at UCSF, the founders are from UCSF or the technology is from UCSF from 2018 onwards. And then we have like best established company, which would be if you were founded pre-2018. Then we have consumer prevention, which is the best digital health product or solution helping patients keep diseases at bay. Then consumer wellness, any digital health product or service aimed at consumers. Then we have one on our website called the Digital Health Hall of Fame. This is actually not something that you can apply for. UCSF Health Hub will give it out to people that have made a significant contribution in this field. Then we have employer wellness and prevention, so anything dedicated towards employee wellness or prevention, but it's targeted towards employers. And then hospital diagnostics and mental health, which are pretty self-explanatory. Then we have new application of AI, new EHR advance. And for these 2 categories, we wanted to emphasize that it should be a new application of technology and something that we haven't seen before being used in the industry. So really emphasize that new part of it. And then we have patient cost savings. So anything that's helping patients save money. And then the last 2 are remote diagnostics or telemedicine. And so if you guys are thinking like, oh, we have products that apply to maybe multiple of these categories, we really emphasize that you pick the category that you think that you will be able to succeed in and actually win the award. That being said, you are able to apply to at most 2 categories. And from then, I'm going to talk about judging criteria. So we wanna be very transparent with our judging process. We know that's really important to companies. That's very important to us too. So in each round, you're going to see different judging criteria. But the ones that you guys will be facing for the first preliminary round is based on these four parameters. The first one is if it's in market. The second thing is functionality. So does a product or solution deliver as promised? And then validation and customer traction. And this is really important to us this year. And my colleague Rutwick will be going through the application process, and you're going to see that validation and customer traction are very emphasized in the application process. So I'm now going to hand it over to him to explain what it's going to be like to apply through our submissions portal.
Okay. Mary, can you? So good afternoon, everyone. And as we get started, I think for over the next 10 minutes or so, what I want to do is do a short demo and, you know, walk you through the applications process, you know, mainly doing four things. So the first is go over how to create an account and start an application. B, answer some of the more, you know, important and core judging questions. C, upload attachments if that is necessary or appropriate for the application that you're building. And finally, submit the entry that you've created. And, you know, again, like Aniri mentioned, if you do feel, you know, you are eligible for one of more than one categories, we do allow you to apply in up to two categories. So there is an easy and quick way to copy your application from one category to the next. And I'll quickly go over that as well once I do this demo. So for first time users and completely new entrants, what you will first need to do is to register and create your account, which you can, you know, very conveniently do on the AwardsForce platform. And once you do that, you will very promptly get a verification email, you know, so just confirm that. And then your account is, you know, created and you're good to start with the application itself. So I've already started one of these applications. So let me quickly log in into my portal, submission portal, and show you how we kind of go through this. So once you land on the first page of the submission portal, you know, the very first thing that you see is all the important awards information that Andrila and Aniri just went over. So this includes all the different things that were just described, you know, award categories, details related to them, competition rounds, all the important dates and deadlines associated with that, the judging process and the criteria. And then again, you know, all of these are linked back to our awards website and the health hub website itself, you know, so you will be able to navigate back and forth if you need to. And then one final thing that I want to emphasize and, you know, make sure that everyone has understood, you know, through some of the email communication that we've got, we've sent so far, is the fact that, you know, for this specific round that we have opened right now, which is the preliminary round, there is no charge or fee associated with this. However, having said that, once we move to the quarterfinals and the participants or candidates who move into that round, we will charge a one-time fee of $250 to all the quarterfinalists as we move ahead. And we'll send more details as we move towards that in the weeks to come. So having said that, as you scroll down through the very first landing page, for again, you know, for all new entrants, you would probably only see this one tab called Start Entry. But for some of you who might have already started your application or might have already submitted, you know, you would probably see your application already either in progress, which is denoted by the status, or it might say submitted as well. So for this demo, you know, I've created like this one mock application, you know, using a fake company that I've created, and I'll quickly go over that and show how you filled out this application. So as you enter and start walking through your application or entry, the first thing that you will realize is there are three different tabs or sections that you will need to answer to finish your application. The first one is details, the second one is the judging questions, and the third one is attachments, where you would obviously upload attachments if, again, like I said, if it's necessary or, you know, appropriate. So the details tab, which is the very first tab, essentially kind of, you know, tries to take in as much basic information about, you know, the category that you want to apply in, you know, some of the high level details of the company that you are representing or applying from. And at the very end, you know, there are two, you know, prerequisites, like Andrila said, that we do have for, you know, this awards program for 2020. So it kind of goes over that as well. So again, you know, starting at the very top, you know, starting with the category. So the company that I've created is essentially called Health Hub MedTech Solutions. And it fits in within the AI category as far as I, you know, think would be the best category for this, you know, so I've essentially, you know, selected new applications of AI. Having selected that, the entry name gets pre-populated, you know, just based on the registered account. But if you had to go back and change, you know, the person who's entering information or the person who needs to be contacted, you can go do that. The next few fields, like I said, you know, goes over, you know, getting some of that company information, company tagline, the URL, the CEO information, you know, the logo, the year your company was founded in. And at the very end, there are these two fields, which, like I said, you know, are, you know, hard prerequisites for, you know, this awards program. So we do need you to be based in North America, and we do need you to have an in-market solution. You know, so I've, you know, obviously selected yes for both of these. And at this point, you know, once we have done finishing, you know, filling out details in the very first section, there are one of two things that you could do. So you could click on save and next, which would take you directly to the judging questions. Or for some reason, if you do feel that, you know, you want to kind of finish your application in more than one setting, what we would then advise you to do is, you know, click on save and close. So it saves your application in progress, and then you can re-log in and revisit your application maybe on a later time or date. So for now, I'm going to click save and go next, which will take me to the judging questions. And before I go through all the judging questions and, you know, how I've, you know, briefly answered them, representing the mock company that I've created, the first thing that I want to point your attention to is the fact that for each of the questions that we have in the judging tab, there is a description on the side or a prompt which, you know, helps you understand the question a little better. So let's say for the first one, we are trying to, you know, start with, you know, what specific problem does your technology uniquely solve? And there is a prompt which basically says, we are trying to kind of understand, you know, and ask you to describe the challenge that your technology is uniquely solving in the context of the category that you selected. For additional benefit, one other feature that we've added is, you know, if you still need, you know, more information about how best to answer questions, you can go over and click on the help question. And what it will do is it will show up a sample response that we've created for all of the fields in the judging questions. You know, so this again, we believe, you know, will be useful and helpful as you navigate through all the judging questions. So for the mock company that I, you know, first told you about that I've created, you know, I've answered some of these questions in brief, and I'll go over them very quickly. So the company that I'd created is called Health Hub MedTech Solutions. And what we essentially do is we've created an AI solution which recognizes, you know, lesions on colonoscopy when, you know, GI docs or gastroenterologists are performing these procedures. You know, so starting with the very first question, what specific problem does your technology uniquely solve? And I've listed three problems that currently exist. So there is an increasing burden of colon cancer, let's say in the country, GI docs are overwhelmed and need help with diagnosis. The second thing is, again, too many lesions are missed and turn out to be cancer later. The third thing is, again, you know, procedures take too long or need to be repeated, you know, because of misdiagnosis, as mentioned above. Going on to the second question, this is where you describe your technology, product, or solution in brief. And again, you know, the way I've kind of described this is to try and highlight, you know, some of the salient features of our product. So our product is a machine learning based software, which runs during the procedure in real time and stores data in a cloud, which is securely held and which is HIPAA compliant. Moreover, because this is an AI solution, you know, we want to make sure that, you know, the AI comes across, which is as well trained over a robust and diverse data set of over 100,000 images and videos of colonoscopy. The next question essentially is, you know, how is your technology different from other offerings available in the category? And then again, you know, this is where we want you to differentiate between your technology, product, or solution from something which might be existing in the market already, or, you know, which again is something that you can differentiate with your competitors. And the sample answer that I've listed here is, you know, our technology that our company builds is the first in class where GI docs get diagnosis aid during the procedure, which is in real time. It is compatible with multiple devices and vendors, so it can work across, you know, different, you know, settings as well. And the third is, this is the first AI algorithm for GI diagnosis that had to be FDA approved. That was FDA approved. The next question again is, you know, to try and understand who your target customers and users are. And this again, I think we realize the fact that, you know, in a healthcare ecosystem, you know, there could be multiple customers or users who could be either physicians, patients, payers, you know, hospitals, clinics, you know, if it's a B2C solution, you know, this could be just end consumers. So you can potentially list down a bunch of these who you think your target customers or users are. And also, having said that, you know, sometimes we do also come across the fact that, you know, the customers of your product or solutions could be one and the end users could be someone else. So like in this example, for our company, the customers and the buyers are essentially hospitals or hospital networks, But the actual end users of the technology are gastroenterologists who use this technology during their procedures. The next question again is, to do with, understanding about, in-market validation. So we ask you about how many customers have actually used your solution or are currently using your technology. And you can get as granular as you want with this answer, specifying the number of people using this, either it be at a provider level or at a patient level. If your technology or if your company is essentially more of a B2C, again, where you're, let's say, building an app, you could also mention the number of monthly active users or the number of downloads that have happened in your device or for your app. So this is that place where you can kind of emphasize things of that sort. So for this example, I've said we do have 6 paying customers, which are hospitals in California and the Pacific Northwest region. And we are being actively used by 20 GI docs as of now. The other thing that you could also do to kind of also emphasize your growth potential to the judges is if you have, customers or contracts in the pipeline. So for my company, I would want to say that we have 3, paying customers in the pipeline who will be added in Q3 of 2020. So this is again a great way to let the judges know where you stand with customer validation. The next question again is, how have you made it easier for your target audience to use your technology? And this is fairly self-explanatory. So the way I've responded is, our AI solution integrates, well within the existing, clinical workflow. There is minimal training required, and a lot of the data that is eventually captured during the procedure integrates very seamlessly with the EHR. The next question again is, does the product deliver as promised, share a validation proof or a verified success story? And this is again one of those things where, getting feedback from the judging process last year, a lot of our judges actually wanted to know if the technology or the solution that many of these companies have been built have been, validated scientifically, clinically, or in the real market, so to speak. And there are 2 things that you can do at this point, so the way I've done this is I've basically said, we do have 1 peer reviewed paper and some survey feedback from, 100 GI docs that we had interviewed after they tried a solution. And additionally, you can also then, provide relevant attachments in the next step, and I'll show you when we get to that, but you can essentially mention that you've had some attachments provided at this point as well. The next 2 questions are again fairly obvious. They ask you about, is your product reimbursed by some kind of insurance payer? Select the one which is most appropriate. This could be yes, it could be in progress. For some of the companies, reimbursement might not be applicable. So go ahead and select the best one applicable for you. And the penultimate again is, is your technology FDA approved? Again, it's a drop-down option. It might be approved, it might be pending, or maybe your technology or your product doesn't need FDA approval. So I'm going to go ahead and select FDA approved. Finally, coming to the last question, which is, tell us why you should win this category. And think of this question as taking that opportunity to recap the most salient features about your company, your product, or your solution for the judges. So that this is the takeaway that they finally walk away with, once they've, looked at your company, gone through all, the judging questions and attachments, if any. And for this one, the way I've tried to summarize this is, our solution is the first in class solution. There is seamless integration with existing clinical workflows. It reduces misdiagnosis by 30%. It saves GI docs time, 25% of times per procedure. So this is essentially what I want the judges to know when they think of my company after they've reviewed my application. And then again, at this point, if you do have attachments, what you want to do is click save and go next, which will take you to the attachments tab. Again, we have all the instructions listed out above, and I've attached two documents as a sample right now. There are only 2 things that I will quickly go over in the interest of time. So the first thing is, once you attach your documents, make sure to kind of go and pick the appropriate category in which your attachment belongs to. So this could be photos, or this could be documents related to product demos, technology. It could be publications, case studies, or other validation studies. And then finally, I think just one last request to everyone is, if you do have videos that you want to share with the judges, do not directly upload them to the attachments. In any case, the max file size is 5 MB. So in most probability, you will not be able to upload a video. The thing that you want to do in that case is, provide the link within a doc. If there is a video of a demo or, of the product that you've built, you could probably provide it that way. So that would be much easier for everyone. And finally, I think, once you feel you're confident that, you've completed the entire, applications process, the last thing that you might want to do is to actually preview the entire application in one glance. So if you click preview, it will basically kind of take you through the entire application that you filled out, you know, going through all the different fields, the attachments that you've uploaded, and just quickly scrolling down, you can, you know, briefly glance, you know, if everything looks okay. You can always go back and make edits if there are anything that needs to be changed. If not, and if you feel confident, you can then go ahead and submit entry. So I'm, at this point, I'm just going to go ahead and do that. So I'm going to click submit entry. And what you will see at that point is, you know, you will see a confirmation that you've completed your entry submission at that point. You will also get a verification email at that point, confirming that you've completed your submission. One of the questions that we have, you know, gotten from some people is what happens once you are done with submissions? Can you go back and edit? The short answer is yes. You know, so do not worry or do not panic if you think, you know, on a later date, if you need to, you know, edit or add some more information. So even after you submitted your entries, what you can do is you can go back to your application, edit things if needed. And this will be open until 3rd of August. This is until when we close the preliminary rounds. One last thing that I want to go over very quickly before I, you know, complete the demo is the fact that many of you might, you know, want to apply in more than one categories. And for this year, we've decided to let companies apply in a max of up to 2 categories. And this could be either one of 2 ways. So your company might have more than one product which might be eligible in, you know, these 2 categories that you feel most strongly about. So in case if you're going and, you know, making an entry about a second category, you will probably start the similar way, start the entry, you know, fill out the entire application and click submit. But in case if you're going to use the same product or the same technology that you describe for a second category, in the interest of saving time, there is a quick hack to kind of allow you to do this very quickly. So what you want to do is you want to select your existing application that is either in progress or has been submitted. Click on this, select this, and just go click copy. And in a few seconds, you will essentially, I think this takes a few seconds. So let's give this a couple of seconds more. Yeah. So what you do see is in a few seconds, there is an exact copy that gets generated. And the only thing that you might want to then do is go into the second copy, you know, re-edit the category or maybe make some other, you know, high level changes if you had to. So that's a very quick and easy way to kind of, you know, copy your existing application into a different category. So at this point, you know, there is just one last clarification that I will make, which is the fact that all the different categories that you will come across have the same, you know, same set of judging questions. So it is okay if you want to kind of go create a copy for a second category. It will not, you know, disturb or, you know, change anything in that sense. And having said that, you know, I'm going to kind of stop right now. This was clearly a bunch of, you know, information to process in the over a period of 10-20 minutes. But at this point, I just want to make sure, you know, things are clear or if there are questions about the actual application process that I can answer to.
Right. Thank you, Ruthvekana and Eri. So if you're free to unmute yourselves and ask us a question or put it on the chat box or email us either ways, because we are at 4:30, but like, if you have to drop off, you are free to email us or you can unmute yourself and ask us the question. And we have the recording of this call. We will be sharing it with everyone. In case there are more questions, you are free to join our next office hours as well.
So we do have one question and I'll quickly go over this. So the question asks, our company is US-based. However, the product is yet to be marketed in the US market, but is being used in Asia, Africa, Europe, etc. We are also present in Mexico, though.
I think you should apply because our thing is it should be based in North America. And I think if it's already available in some markets, it'll be great if you apply. Ultimately, it's up to our judging panel. But like, it'll be great for you to apply. What we are going to do is we have our email addresses already. For people who have participated last year, you're free to apply in the same or the different category. Only for the winners of a particular category last year, we would ask them to apply in a different category. But if you were just participants, you're free to choose any category. Are there any other eligibility requirements? No, we just want the company to be based out of North America, and we want you to have an in-market solution.
And just to add to this, if you have additional questions that pop up, you know, later through your application process, you know, you can always reach us, either me or Andrela, by email. So do feel free to always reach out if there are questions about the awards program or the application process. We would be happy to answer questions at any point.
Okay, what we're going to do is just type our email addresses here, just in case you need them, but they're also available with you on the different emails. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Okay, so if we do not have any more questions, I wish everyone a great, happy weekend, and we'll kind of help you through the process as we move forward. But we're definitely very excited to have you on board to participate this year. Thank you all.
Thank you.